Praise the Lord, friends. Hope you are doing well. Today is December 6th, and our point of reflection goes like this. Their rather easy way on the level ground reached the city of Megiddo. The pious Jews saw the place where Ahaz was killed. His body was taken to David's city and buried. They spoke devoutly of their king David. The merchants in the caravan went to the city for their purchases. Joseph and Mary used the occasion for their much needed rest. They were in good company and they prayed the Psalms of David or recalled the Proverbs of Solomon. Grateful were they to God and His providence. Let us reflect. Am I a person who is thankful? Mary's thanksgiving was thus: The Mighty One has done great things for me, and holy is His name. Luke 1:49. Today, let me decide that I will find a lonely spot where I will sit prayerfully, thanking God for all He did for me from my birth onwards to this day. This will be my personal litany of thanks. Abraham Joshua Herzl tells us, only one attitude will sustain us, and that is gratitude. Seeing our very life and all the conveniences, all given freely and unmerited, we become all wondering and thanking. What I am to others is directly to God Himself. Matthew 25:40. To everyone who helps me, I will pleasantly and expressively say thank you. And to practice this attitude of gratitude, thanksgiving, I can also learn equivalent expressions in other languages so that I can thank them in their native tongue. After my death, when I stand before God, I will utter only one word: thanks. An eternity is needed to live its meaning. Saint Basil, Doctor of the Church. Friends, let us pray that God may give us the attitude of gratitude in our day-to-day life. Let us all be thankful for innumerous blessings that God showers upon us directly or through our brothers and sisters. May God bless us all. Thank you. Have a nice day.